हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवन फ्रॉम डिजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 85। द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी हैव आस्क्ड व्हाट्सएप टू विथड्रॉ इट्स कंट्रोवर्शियल प्राइवेसी पॉलिसी। व्हाट्सएप हैज 7 डेज टू रेस्पॉन्स टू द मिनिस्ट्रीज नोटिस, अदरवाइज इट कुड रन इन टू लीगल ट्रबल। अर्लियर व्हाट्सएप थ्रेटन्ड टू डिलीट द अकाउंट्स ऑफ यूजर्स हू फेल्ड टू एक्सेप्ट इट्स न्यू प्राइवेसी पॉलिसी। इट इज नॉट जस्ट प्रॉब्लमैटिक बट ऑल्सो इररेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर व्हाट्सएप टू लेवरेज दिस पोजिशन टू इम्पोज अनफेयर टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस ऑन इंडियन यूजर्स। PUBG Mobile's India variant Battlegrounds Mobile India could release on June 18th. A report suggests that PUBG Mobile was banned in the country back in September 2020. South Korean developer Krafton has not shared a release date for Battlegrounds Mobile India, but it is in the process of finalizing it. The game is already up for pre-registration in the country for Android users through its Google Play Store. However, the game's community of users reportedly believes that Battlegrounds Mobile India could release on June 10th. The OnePlus Watch is a wearable with a 1.4-inch OLED display and a $159 price tag. It is offered in black and silver, but fans in China will get a new limited edition variant. The watch will be named as OnePlus Watch Cyberpunk 2077 and will arrive in China on May 24 with some visual differences. OnePlus Watch is the brand's first smartwatch. This wearable was announced alongside the OnePlus 9 series. At the end of the launch event, the company teased a Harry Potter limited edition for this watch. Now an APK teardown of this OnePlus Health app confirms the existence of a special variant. OnePlus phone with Dimensity 1200 processor is expected to launch soon. This could be the OnePlus Note 2, and OnePlus Note 2 launch is going to take place in mid-June. The founder and CEO of OnePlus, Pete Liu, announced that Li Qiaxin will be officially joining the company. The newly appointed official is also a former executive of Huawei and 360 Mobile. The founder stated that he has known Li Qiaxin to have successfully led Huawei in China and even helped the brand achieve 10 times of millions of sales. And Pete Liu also stated that newly appointed official and industry veteran, especially in terms of smartphone sales. Oppo India has just announced the new My Oppo app for the region. It offers its Indian customer an easier method to access the community and even follow them to seek support for any issues. As per the press release, the Chinese tech giant announced that it seeks to furthermore improve the user experience of its customer base in the country. This new app will serve as a platform for user interaction with other members of the community to share their own experience and get direct support as well. This community also brings with the benefits that users can avail directly. Today, Oppo has confirmed that it will launch the Oppo Reno 6 series on May 27th in China. As per the latest report, the Reno 6 will be run on the latest MediaTek Dimensity 900 processor and has a 4300 mAh battery that will support 65W fast charging. The Poco M3 Pro 5G is here and it is faster. It has a faster internet thanks to 5G, it has a faster 90Hz screen and a faster chipset, and it is a cool new design too. Poco picked the 7nm Dimensity 700 chip to power its new creation. It has peak download speeds up to 2.77 Gbps and a pair of Cortex A76 cores plus a Mali G57 GPU. Qualcomm Snapdragon 778 processor, the mid-variant system on chip between Snapdragon 750G and 780G, was announced during the Snapdragon Tech Summit 2021 on Wednesday. The new chip will be used in high-end smartphones from companies like Honor, Xiaomi, Motorola, Realme and IQ, etc. Realme will be the one of the first few companies to do that. And it has already announced that upcoming Quicksilver phone will be based on the new chipset. Honor has also announced that its Honor 50 series will be powered by Snapdragon 778G processor. Realme today announced that it will soon be launching a new brand under its Tech Life division. The new brand called D will be making a global debut via a special event on May 25. The company made an announcement via Realme Tech Life and Realme India Twitter handles. It will start with a dream which led to discovery of new design and development. To produce something different, the first brand in our ecosystem, join us for the global launch on May 25th, the company wrote it in a poster on Twitter. Realme X7 Max India launch has been officially teased. This handset is expected to be rebranded of Realme GT Neo. Realme X7 Max will be the first phone in India with MediaTek Dimensity 1200 processor. Realme X7 Max India launch date is yet to be revealed. OnePlus is one of the smartphone manufacturer whose device has joined the Android 12 beta testing program. It was decided to run the firmware of the OnePlus 9 and OnePlus 9 Pro, but in less than a day, the manufacturer had to withdraw the update due to the serious problem. According to Android Police, the problem was caused by the users themselves who simply forgot to unlock the bootloader. Enthusiasts have already found a solution to a problem by offering a tool that uses Qualcomm's chipset emergency boot mode to unlock the device. Not everything is going
smoothly with the installation of Android 12 on the Xiaomi M11 as well. The comments about the malfunctioning of the smartphone after installing the update began to appear on Twitter. At the moment, the solution to the problem is not available and the company does not comment on it anyway. Google I/O 2021 is presently ongoing this year on a virtual basis due to the prevailing COVID-19 pandemic. One of the fallouts from the ongoing event is an announcement that active devices running the Android operating system have gone beyond 3 billion.
As a part of the I/O festivities, Google has just announced its plan to make Android phones into Android TV compatible remotes. Of course, that's already a thing, but Google wants to build this into an Android itself, and it should make everything from setting up a new service to finding a new show to watch that much easier.
Bitcoin, Dogecoin prices along with that of other popular cryptocurrencies such as Ether, Matic and Binance coin fell sharply on Wednesday, leading to a trading rush that Indian exchanges struggled to manage. Bitcoin, the largest and the most popular cryptocurrencies in the world with a market cap of over $1 trillion, that is around 73 lakh crore, was trading dangerously close to 30,000, that is roughly around 22 lakh at around 7 p.m. IST on Wednesday, a 20% dip before showing a quick recovery, according to data from Binance, a global cryptocurrency exchange that also convert Wazirex in India. Dogecoin price saw a more dramatic fall and dipped to a low as $0.26, that is approximately 19 rupees, has only managed a partial recovery so far. Infinix Hot 10S price in India starts from 9,999 Indian rupees. The Android ships with MediaTek Helio G85 processor and a 48-megapixel triple cameras, and it comes with a 90Hz HD+ display. Infinix Hot 10S sale date in India has yet to be revealed. There is a new flagship from Nubia called the Z30 Pro, and it brings a compelling camera experience with 364-megapixel shooters alongside Qualcomm's best Snapdragon 888 and a 144Hz refresh rate display. If these speculations sound familiar, it's because we have seen them in ZTE's Axon 30 Ultra, which launched last month. In March, Xiaomi announced the Redmi Note 10 series of smartphone in India and global markets. Today, the Chinese brand released an official poster through its Weibo handle to confirm that it will be announcing the Note 10 5G series at 2 p.m. on May 26th in China. The official poster gives a glimpse of one of the Note 10 series smartphone. The recent reports have claimed that Redmi Note 10 5G lineup for China includes three handsets such as Vanilla Note 10 5G, Note 10 Pro and Note 10 Pro Plus 5G. Xiaomi has a portfolio of mobile accessories including power bank, earphones and cases in India. The company launched crowdfunding for the Mi Boost Pro power bank 30,000 mAh back in March. After a successful crowdfunding campaign, Xiaomi is finally launching the power bank in Indian market. Xiaomi took it to the social media channels to announce that the power bank Boost Pro will launch in India on May 21st. The power bank was priced at ₹1,999 during the crowdfunding campaign. Xiaomi has been significant growth in the past year, and the Chinese company has now become the third largest smartphone vendor globally in terms of shipping volume, sitting just behind Samsung and Apple. The company has several popular lineups, and one of them is a Redmi Note series. As per the latest numbers revealed by Xiaomi, so far the company has shipped more than 200 million units of Redmi Note series smartphone globally. It has also shared an overall number and not individual figures for each generation in the lineup. Mi Smart Band 6 is the latest fitness tracker from Xiaomi. Soon after its release, the Mi Band 6 got a firmware update for features related to sleep tracking. Now Xiaomi is rolling out another update for this wearable, which bumps up the firmware version to 1.0.1.32. The latest firmware update for the Mi Band 6 arrives with Mi Fit version 5.1.0. Hence, in order to install the new firmware, user will have to update the Mi Fit app from the Play Store, Get Apps, Mi App Store and Apple App Store. According to the official changelog, the new update adds supports for text message replies. Hawaii is apparently planning on selling cars from 200 of its experience stores by the end of July 2021. It is also reportedly targeting a shipment goal of 300,000 units for the next year. According to the Bloomberg report, the news arrives from Patrick Kaye, Executive Director of the European Union Aviation Safety Agencies. The official made the statement in an online event earlier this week. Patrick Kaye further added the autonomous drones will take at least 5 years more, while larger aircraft are expected to follow soon after. Furthermore, ESA has just started to work with companies on how to address unmanned flight. As per the regulator, the agency is also working closely with the US Federal Aviation Administration and other international regulators as well. Patrick Kaye stated that it's easier to start the A-taxi based vehicle because we are looking for a smaller scale aircraft. We have not gone too far because it requires a lot of thinking on how you want to deal with the autonomous concepts. Samsung introduced the Galaxy F62 in Feb, and now it has expanded its portfolio of the Galaxy F series with the Galaxy F52 5G. The Samsung Galaxy F52 5G is built around a 6.6-inch Full HD Plus TFT screen with 120Hz refresh rate, and it also has a punch hole in the top right of the corner for the 16MP selfie shooter. Around the back, we get a 64MP primary camera joined by 8MP ultra-wide-angle camera, 2MP of depth sensor camera, and a 2MP of macro units. The Galaxy F52 5G has a Snapdragon 750G processor with a 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. It also has a micro SD card slot for storage expansion up to 1TB. On the software side, we have an Android 11 with One UI 3.1 on top. The smartphone also comes with several third-party applications which fortunately are uninstallable.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.